Christ is risen. Hey there guys, Father Photius here with another video on the parables of our Lord Jesus Christ. This evening we have three very short parables, so short that I will read them to you from the text itself. And this is from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and hid. And for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is likened to a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a dragnet that was cast into the sea and gathered some of every kind, which when it was full, they drew to shore. And they sat down and gathered the good into vessels, but threw the bad away. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come forth, separate the wicked from among the just, and cast them into the furnace of fire. There will be wailing and gnashing of teeth. So, the kingdom of heaven is like three things. Like a treasure hidden in a field, like a pearl of great price, and like a net cast into the sea. What's the significance of each of these parables? What is at the heart of these? When we look at the first two parables, that of the treasure hidden in the field and the pearl of great price, what the Lord is communicating to us is the cost of the kingdom of heaven. That the kingdom of heaven is going to cost everything. It's not going to be entered into passively by anyone. It's not, oh, well, I said my little prayer and I've got Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior and that's that. No, no. It's going to cost everything. Yes, saying the prayer is the way it starts. It's a good start, okay? But you got to keep going. It's going to cost you everything. What is the difference, I would ask, with regard to the treasure hidden in the field and the pearl of great price? That with the treasure hidden in the field, this seems to indicate that attaining this treasure, attaining the kingdom of heaven, is going to require some patience, and it's going to require some silence. The treasure found in the field, it's not like the guy goes and blabs, you know, what he's found and tells everybody else about it. No, because he doesn't want them going and getting it. He knows about it, and so he quietly sells everything that he has so that he can go and buy the field. And once he has the field, then that treasure is all his. Okay, I think about this with regard to new converts. The best thing for someone who is new to the Orthodox faith to do is be quiet, listen, and read. Too many times I see catechumens and new converts getting online and being loud and being even vulgar with what they have found. You know, they have become Orthodox and all the rest of you losers can just lick their boots. That's the tone that many come across with, and it's really off-putting. The kingdom of heaven is not won in this way, and indeed one will not be able to hold on to the kingdom of heaven if one goes about it in this manner. With regard to the pearl of great price, the pearl is plain for all to see. All can see this thing, which is wonderful and magnificent, but which is thoroughly expensive. And here, I think what is hinted at is the element of patience. The element of patience in attaining that thing, which once you have attained it, is worth everything. It's worth everything that you have sold. With regard to the dragnet, which is cast into the sea and brings in all kinds of different fish, the good and the bad. The bad are thrown away and the good are kept. It's important for us to remember that with this particular parable, the bad who get taken in with the net are not those out in the world. In other words, they're not the darnel weeds that we saw in the parable of the wheat and the darnel weeds, the tares. They're not the tares. The tares are those out there who are wicked and have never heard the gospel or have only, you know, seen a distorted version of it. Okay, those brought in with the dragnet, those belong to the church. Those are the people of the church. And the bad, who are gathered together and put into the furnace, are those Christians who have only been Christians in the nominal sense. Okay, they got baptized, they went to communion once a year, they came on Pascha, oh Father, bless my basket, please. Okay, there, I got my Jesus points for the year, hooray. Okay, that's, and that's all they invested in it. Okay, the nominal Christian, the basic Christian. Oh, well, yes, my parents are from this country, so I'm Orthodox. No, that's not it. In order to be kept with this catch, in order to be kept, one has to give everything that one has. And so these parables give us a very powerful reminder that the kingdom of heaven is indeed going to cost us everything. So God bless you and keep you, and we'll see you tomorrow night. Bye-bye.